Raju woke up in the morning and got dressed for school. He had his breakfast and headed out. Each morning, his father dropped him to the school in his car. Today, his father seemed worried. He told Raju,
"Son, there is some problem with our car. Let's catch a bus to go to the school today."
The bus stop was a short distance away from Raju's home. They caught a rickshaw and reached the bus stop. Then they boarded the bus to Raju's school and bought their tickets. Today, Raju reached school earlier than usual. He was surprised. Upon reaching the classroom, he shared the morning incident with his teacher. How the car developed some problem and he had to catch the bus to school. Raju admitted that he had great fun while journeying in the bus. I'm glad to know that you enjoyed the bus ride, Raju. Now go to your seat. Today we will discuss a related topic in the class. Students, today we will talk about all the things that help us get from here to there. Okay, tell me, how do you all come to school?
My home is close by. I simply walk to the school.
I travel in the school bus.
I ride an auto to school.
And Raju gets dropped to school in his father's car. But today, he had to take the public bus because his car broke down. What determines your mode of travel to school? The distance between your home and the school, and the kind of vehicles which run in our city. Let's understand means of transport. Means of transport are of three kinds: land, water, and air. Land transport includes roads and railways.
Ma'am, all these modes of transport did not exist in old times. Did human walk to every places at that time?
Good question. In ancient times, vehicles like car, bus, and auto, of course, did not exist. It would take a long time even to cover short distances. So human beings used animals as means of transport. They rode on horses, elephants, and camels to cover distances. These animals are used till date to go from here to there. As civilization progressed, new vehicles were invented and created. The first and very important invention was a wheel. Students, can you name some two-wheeled vehicles?
Cycle, scooter.
And three-wheeled vehicles?
Rickshaw, auto.
And vehicles with four wheels?
Car, bullock cart.
And more than four wheels?
Bus, truck, train.
Now tell me, do we also have vehicles without wheels?
A boat.
Absolutely right. The boat, which floats on water, does not have any wheels. One more thing. Vehicles run on different kind of fuel. Some vehicles like scooter, car, and truck run on gas, petrol, or diesel. Some like metro rail run on electricity. Some like bullock cart and tonga are pulled by animals. And some like rickshaws are pulled by humans. Now, a question for all of you. Are vehicles only used to transport humans from here to there?
No, ma'am. Vehicles are also used to transport goods. An example of this is the malgadi or freight train.
Absolutely right. Other examples of such vehicles are cart, truck, etc. Some vehicles like tractors are used in farming. And some are called emergency vehicles. They come to the aid of public during emergency situations. Examples of such vehicles are police van, ambulance, and fire truck. In olden times, it used to take many days to travel from one city to another. Now, one can simply board a train and reach another town in a matter of hours. In fact, you can board a plane and reach an entirely different country in a couple of hours. There are boats to cross rivers and ships to cross oceans. We have so many vehicles to fulfill the need for transport. Now, who will recap today's lesson for us?
Ma'am, today we learned about the various means of transport. We learned how today's vehicles are different from those of old days. We identified vehicles with different number of wheels. And you told us about various kinds of fuel on which different vehicles run. At the end, we learned about vehicles which help in emergency situations, in farming and in transportation of goods.
Well done, Raju. See you tomorrow, students. Bye-bye.